day.
I'm sorry.
He's trying to show me up, man.
I apologize.
Okay. Yeah,
right.
Okay.
Excellent, Dad. Thank you so much. No. I was a good student. I just couldn't get into math. Couldn't see how it could relate to the real world. What? What did I say?
I think you're about to find out.
You guys are on your own. Good luck.
Math is the real world, okay? It's everywhere, okay? Hey, can I show you?
Please.
You see how the petals spiral? The number of petals in each row is the sum of the preceding two rows, the Fibonacci sequence. It's found in the structure of crystals and the spiral of galaxies in a nautilus shell.
That's amazing.
What's more, the ratio between each number in the sequence to the one before it is approximately 1.61803, what the Greeks called the golden ratio. It shows up. Pyramids at Giza, and in the Parthenon at Athens, and the dimensions of this card. And it's based on a number you can find in a flower. Math is nature's language, its method of communicating directly with us. So, everything is numbers.
Okay, well, when you explain it like that, it's a lot more interesting.
Well, it seems like your new math consultant's working out nicely.
I gotta tell you, Dad, I can't think of anyone who could have helped us the way Charlie did in the investigation.
Just remember how Charlie is. Can't seem to quit a problem. He's still working on the same one he's had since grade school.
And what's that?
Trying to impress his big brother.
Yeah, and I've given that exact speech to my junior class.
Have you ever had a slow motion?
He is going to test the recurrence of the untwinnable moment.
You bank me,
we're not keeping you for helping us out on yet another investigation. Well done.
Well, it's always a pleasure to help the feds and the academic routine.
Yeah, I'm far.